Look at him. Okay. Big, beautiful, large mouth. Look at him.
Hey guys, first off, let me thank you for watching our YouTube channel and learning more ways to catch bass, walleye, crappie, anything that swims. I like to fish for it, and hopefully I can share my knowledge and experiences with you. So let's just get right to the meat of the episode. You know I love to fish with heavy stuff for bass. If I can pick up that casting rod, something tells me I'm fishing for big bass when I got that casting rod in my hand. Now you know I love to pick up the spinning rod when I have to, but that casting rod, it was born in my hand. It's in my DNA. But on this episode, we're going to talk about fishing pressured lakes, especially clear water lakes where bass can be a little spooky. Okay, especially if guys been through those areas just before you and stuff. You got to find ways to catch fish when you go fishing. Sounds simple, right? But sometimes you just got to put the jig down, put the creature bait down, and just pick up baits like this here. Now what's that? It's a finesse worm. And it's a fat bodied finesse worm, rigged the same way I do when I put a creature bait or a bigger worm fishing for largemouth, and especially in Northern Ontario, smallmouth inhabit the exact same areas as those largemouth. So you never know what you're going to be surprised with. But the way I rig it, the way I fish it, is unique because I can pick up that medium heavy and heavy power casting rod, go in those areas, dissect the little meaty hot spots and stuff, and look for the obscure little spots where this little worm just shines.
All right, on this segment, we're going to talk about fishing with the fat baby finesse rigged on heavy power rod, casting rod. You know, when I fish with this worm, split shot rigs for smallmouth and stuff, and I'm going to fish a really popular lake, clear water. We just try to dissect trees, rocks, points, different things with that little fat worm. It's just another piece of the arsenal to help you catch fish. So I'll show you the tools of how I do it with the little finesse, using the power poles, keeping the trolling motor on low, and just dissecting areas like these trees, bushes, pads and stuff, and trying to find fish and then force them with the power of the heavy rod so I can make them fight, you know, not just spinning rod stuff. This is gonna be about powering, hitting them, pull them to the boat, kiss them and release them. So when I get the trees like this, when I'm comfortable about here, it's poles down, man. Poles down, because sometimes the fish come towards you and you only see them at the last minute. And if you're moving, good luck. All right, this is the business end right here. The 7.4 Heavy Power Legend X by St. Croix. Low profile, casting reel, Tatula by Daiwa. Nice and smooth. I can make long pitches. And this here is not about the finesse you think about. You know, you say, okay, you said finesse worm and stuff. That's it right there. A little fat baby finesse, but rigged on a 3-odd wide gap hook, on a 3/16 tungsten weight, slow fall. I'm gonna be fishing all shoreline stuff. You know, picking apart little things, depressions, trees, bushes, points of rock, different things like that, you know? So I want it to fall slow. It's a small worm, but I mean, it's just another option.
Okay, places where I fish this little worm, exact same locations I do when the fish are on a hard bite, okay, with the jig or a big creature bait, craw bait, you name it, flip tube, exact same areas, but just that little slender toned down profile is what it takes sometimes to catch fish and not put the boat on the trailer and know that, man, I did love throwing that jig all day, but that stubbornicity today didn't put a lot of fish in the boat, so sometimes you just gotta alternate that. So picking up that little fat body finesse worm, 3-odd extra wide gap, small tungsten weight, tungsten's heavier than lead, so you can go with a smaller profile, 16-pound gamma edge fluorocarbon, and remember, this little bait can be thrown in all the nothing stuff. What's nothing stuff? Things when you're going along a shoreline and bank and stuff, and you're looking to your left, or looking to your left, looking to your right, and you see that log, the shadows and stuff. Even in crystal clear tap-like water, sometimes you can't see the bass. You know, there's like chameleons. It is their surroundings. So I suggest when you're fishing the docks, the trees and rocks and things that are very visible, look around. Polarization in your eyewear take your time, put the poles down, fish slow, keep your foot back and forth on slow in the trolling motor. If you believe bass are there, there's a good chance there'll be bass there. And if they see that little worm presented by a little log that looks like a nothing spot, or especially for smallmouth in Northern Ontario, they inhabit single strands of weed. That's right, one strand of weed in a clear water situation like Simcoe, Coochiching, St. Clair, you name it, a smallmouth and or largemouth could be present. Never pass up pitching the worm to anything you see.
When fish see this, they eat it, man. So I got it on this one, I put 16 pound gamma edge, okay? And the reason is the power finesse. When I hit fish with this, I want to make them fight. I don't want that spinning rod to go all over the place and drag, singing and stuff, because I'm looking for big fish, right? We want to catch big ones, don't you? I do too. I want to power them sometimes. So using the casting rod helps me achieve that. So I make sure that they eat that worm, set that hook, the metal meets the meat, and then fight them to the boat. And my focus obviously is this stuff, but I've got logs, rocks, in your clear water, man, you learn to become a better bass fisherman when you can see the bottom. It's not just about seeing fish activity and fish moving around, but actually just seeing those little subtle breaks, a log or a little bit of a reed, not just what's above the surface. I got the Garmins that show me out to the side, a stump, a rock I won't see, and I'll go over and make a pitch with this little worm. The fish is there, I'm gonna catch him. It's all about dissecting this stuff. Throwing to all the nasty. At least one pitch. And it's not always just the high potential, high visible cover on the shoreline. Keep your wits about you. Look at stuff that's out here. Depressions in the bottom. Different things, man. Fish use that, like right there. Wow, look at that. I just finished singing, huh? Wow, that pulls down. All it was is a few sticks of wood that a beaver made. Wow, good chunky bass. Look at that. He ate that worm. He ate that worm. And the beauty of these little worms, trust me, they're so soft and so smelly that when these things grab them, these things eat them and they don't let go. You see that? Guys would rush in here, trying to fish these trees, probably go over a fish that's sitting on a nothing spot, which is a few pieces of log. That's all that is, a few pieces of log. And there was Mr. Largemouth. But that log is thick. I'm gonna make another pitch right here just to see if a bigger fish could be sitting on the edge of those logs.
All right, what are my favorite colors? You know what? Sometimes you just gotta pick things that go with your gut instinct. And I like the blues and greens with green pumpkin, a little bit of blue flake, and that natural tones. Remember, this is about fishing real clear water. If their water was muddy or off color, tea color, I'd probably be picking up that bigger bait and just pull my hat down and go for it. But this is about fishing those pressured lakes with a lot of boats, a lot of angling pressure, so you have to just tone down a little bit. Now, I've been fishing recently, this last year, with these ones from Net Bait, okay? Little finesse worm, but Okeechobee Craw and Watermelon Red have been two of my favorites. Fantastic little baits. And as incentive and appreciation of you watching our channel, I've got 5 packs of the same worms you see me use in this episode on the Xtreme Angler YouTube channel. I will send to 5 people. Watch the video at the end, skill testing question for a giveaway, and I'll send 5 of you a pack of the exact same worms from this episode.
Hey, rigging a little fat baby finesse. I put it through the very nose of the worm. Turn around, spin it about an inch. Push it up over the shaft, over the line tie. And then take the worm like that down about halfway. Push it up. Bring your bobber stop right against the weight like that. You're up like this here, sitting in there. And see how the hook is protruding, the hook point? I don't want that to happen. So I just take a little bit of it, pinch it up, push it over it like that. It does nothing but help you fish thicker stuff. Doesn't impede the hooking percentages, because when fish bite, boing, it goes down, it's soft plastic. Push it back up, take a little bit of the plastic, push up, push that back down over the point of the hook, and you'll have less frustration because you can pitch into all the scary stuff, rock, wood, bushes, you name it, and not get stuck up until a fish bites. So when I see shade and stuff like that, if there's shade up here, I had everything, not just the tree. I'm only in about, a foot eight. So trolling water going down, so you figure it's about maybe 2 feet. I love fishing that shallow water, fish when it's clear. You gotta learn to fish slower, make longer casts, trust your equipment, and just dissect, man. But the little worm is just an option from the jigs and everything else. Another tool help you catch big fish. By just dissecting, picking apart, making your pitches, looking for things, reading water, a little bit of reeds, a log, all the things in the water. So we're gonna use the power poles with a little finesse worm and hopefully catch some good bass with that little worm and inspire you to say, hey man, I want to start catching some big bass like that guy did with the heavy power rods and the little finesse worm. It's a big log there too. And guess what's there? Yeah, largemouth. Or is it small jaw? Oh, no, it's small jaw, look at that. Small jaw on a worm, huh? Look at that. Fat baby finesse, huh? He ate it too, look at him. He's a good one, look at that. What do you think of that? What do you think of that little worm now, eh? Fat baby finesse gets me a fat baby bass. Look at him, look at him, eh? Look where he's got that. I'd say, oh, you want to eat that little worm, boy. There it is right there. Wow. Nice little smallmouth. Look at that. Look how lean and green. Beautiful, man. But they disappear in the water. Let's put her back right here, huh? Roaming on the rocks, huh? Come on. Wow, 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 wow. Think about that, man. I could fish this with, look at it. I could fish it with spinning rod, you know, light action. But I want to catch those fish and force them to fight hard. So I got it with that 2-odd wide gap hook. Same way I fish for big largemouth, boys. Peg tungsten worm. Come down like that. Rigged it up. And forcing them to fight with the 7.4 Legend X. Low profile. Gonna keep going along, looking for them on a late afternoon here in early summer. Just trying to find fish that have been poked by other guys fishing everywhere, but using fat baby finesse. See that little rocky point? I fish all those big boulders where it comes out, fish the edge of those docks, old cribs and stuff, all the high potential stuff, you say, whatever. I made one pitch off to the side of it, boom, what's there? Nice big smallmouth. And see the way he ate that worm? That worm comes into his realm where he's cruising around looking to eat. He sees that, he eats it. It pays off. Always make that extra pitch. I say it all the time. In your mind, you say, a couple pitches around here. This is a 5-pitch spot, 10-pitch spot, and then leave. Think about it for a sec. If I would have done that, turned the boat around, I would have had no idea that fish is even cruising along those rocks.
All right, which casting rods would you use? I use 7.4. I know you say, isn't it overpowered? Because I'm still going to put that little fat worm in the nasty stuff. That's just my nature, in my DNA. Put it in the crazy, extreme little holes that big bass love to chill in. Smallmouth and largemouth. But a smallmouth sometimes, hanging around those rocks and stuff, hence the 16-pound gamma edge, man. Seriously, you know, you take a chance with bigger bass, they're going to break you off and break your heart. So I'll go with the Legend X 7.4, sometimes 7.1, the medium heavy. They range about 4, 4.5, okay, in the States. Option two, I love these rods, man. The Mojo Bass, okay? This is an opportunity where you can use like the 7.1s, even the Dock Sniper in the Mojo. But again, nothing different. Low profile casting reel, 16-pound edge fluorocarbon. But these rods retail for about 100.5 in the States, a little bit more in different areas. Depends where you shop. Look online, big box stores, but please think about supporting those little mom and pop stores that have been around forever that stock St. Croix rods, because they know craftsmanship never gets old. People know when you say St. Croix, they know what they're buying and it never gets old. You can't go wrong by buying something with the craftsmanship, cork handles, just everything was made for you. Last but not least, all depending on your disposable income. Again, it's not disposable because you're investing. The Bass X, about 110, 100 bucks and stuff, depending on where you buy it. But 7.1, medium heavy, same thing. Quality guides, craftsmanship, the construction of it, cork handles. You can fish all day. It's light enough. And these worms weigh nothing. So there's no reason for fatigue. You just have to focus. Pick the casting rod of your choice. Get out there, catch those fish on those pressured lakes with the little fat worm.
All right, when I'm making those farther pitches with the fluorocarbon, I know there's a little bit of stretch, but in clear water, I'm not gonna take the chance of the braid to the fluoro. I like that straight, brand new line I put on, fresh line, make those smooth pitches and stuff. I know exactly what's happening. And with the Legend X, I mean, if a fish just even goes by my bait, if it breathes on it, smells it, I will know. So you just reel up any slack line and hit them. Don't hit a fish with slack in your line. Two things can happen. Bust your rod, or you make that slack, and if a fish is like 4 or 5 pounds, potentially it's like taking a belt and going slack and pulling it. Hear how loud that is? That's the sound you're gonna hear of your line breaking. Make sure it's tight, lean back. These rods have lots of beef here with the sensitivity. They'll help you so that little hook finds its mark and those fish end up in the boat. Oh boy, lots of rock right here. I think I should put down and fish this right here. Carl's not gonna rush right here. Oh, big. Big. Look at him. Big. Big, beautiful, large mouth. Look at him. You saw my little fat baby finesse, huh? One more jump, gonna turn you. Where are you, hey? Where are you? Come here, come here, come here, come here. Open your mouth. Oh, gotcha. Look at him. Wow, eh? We got another tag on him. Look on top of his fin. Another tag. And look where that worm is. Right there. Wow, huh? Fish in the rocks, hey? Wood, you name it. Pop it out. Oh, you talk about those sharp hooks. Wow. I mean, you know, the fish love that worm when they chase it out from their rocks. Look at that. Isn't that a gorgeous bass? Look at him. Beautiful, heavy largemouth. Beautiful fish. I'll tell you what, I let him go right here, okay? Right here, right now. Look at him. Huh? Ready? Go on. Gone. See what I mean about the power poles? Man, oh man. I fished that little dock, that section by the dock, come around the side, there's just a little few rocks going out. About to turn, I put the poles down, make a few more pitches, bang, 5-pounder comes out and follows me and eats the worm. If I was drifting, I can guarantee you, he'd see the shadow, think I'm Batman or something coming over his head, he would have scooted, gone. Poles down, fish confidently with the little fat baby finesse. And guess what happened? 5-pounder in the boat, baby. Kissed and released. Talk about fishing slow. I gotta do it. Got blown off this afternoon in Main Lake. Look where I am, even in a back bay. And I mean, even got white caps in here. So I'm forced to fish a different spot. But that little fat baby finesse, you've seen me fish it on split shot rigs. You've seen me wacky style it. But this right here, putting it on a 3-odd, extra wide gap, pushing it up, turning it, and fishing it the same way you would largemouth in heavy cover, Texas rigged, right like that. Bring down, bobber stop, right there. That's it right there. They can't resist it, man.
All right, so there you have it. Fishing the little fat worm, everything from A to Z, how to catch them, largemouth and smallmouth, pressured lakes, clear water, all the conditions against you, the odds are against you, but you can still pick up that casting rod, fish with a finesse worm, and catch bass. You don't have to pick up the spinning rod. You can still do what I do, power those fish, get them in the boat. And as promised, 5 packs of these baits. All you got to do is just comment what you liked about the video. Any questions, I'll be there to answer it. Hopefully you subscribe to our channel. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll answer your questions because I appreciate your time watching my time putting the videos together for you. Until I see you next time, fish smart, fish safe.